Welcome to the Azure Active Directory Architectural Video Series. My name is Gloria Lee, and I'm a program manager in the Azure AD engineering team.
Hi, I'm Ravi Vennapuse. I'm also a program manager in the Azure AD engineering team here at Microsoft.
In the previous video, we described how Hybrid Azure AD Join works. In this video, we'll explain how user authentication works after a device is joined to Azure AD. Please note that the authentication to Azure AD is the same for both Azure AD Join devices and Hybrid Azure AD Join devices. Ravi, can you walk us through how the Azure AD authentication works in Windows devices, please?
Sure, Gloria. First, let's take a look at how it works in a federated environment. Authentication with Azure AD starts after a user enters their credentials. This credential could be a password or a passwordless credential like Windows Hello for Business, FIDO 2, or even a smart card. Before we dive in, I'd like to call out that the authentication mechanism to an on-premises Active Directory varies based on the credential used, but in this video, we'll not be covering that. To recall what we discussed during the device registration videos, in a federated environment, we require the federated identity provider to support the AWS Trust Protocol and enable the relevant endpoints. When a user enters the credentials, Windows logon passes these credentials to the cloud authentication provider called Cloud AP. Cloud AP uses the user's domain to identify where the user should authenticate. This is referred to as home realm discovery in Azure AD. In a federated environment, Azure AD refers to the federated identity provider's AWS Trust Metadata Exchange or MEX endpoint. That endpoint returns to the client all the authentication methods it supports. In our example, we are assuming that the user is authenticating with a password. But if the user uses a smart card to log on, then you need to publish the certificate MEX endpoint on your identity provider. On successful authentication, the identity provider returns the SAML token back to Cloud AP. Cloud AP now signs the SAML token with the private key of the device that was generated during device registration and sends this as part of the request to Azure AD. One important thing to note is that the Cloud AP does not have direct access to these keys. Instead, it invokes the Trusted Platform Module or TPM to sign the request. The TPM is a hardware crypto component on the device that securely stores these keys to prevent unauthorized access. Now, Azure AD validates the SAML token issued by your IDP, validates the device signature, and issues a primary refresh token to the device. In addition, Azure AD also secures the PRT by sending a proof of position key called the session key, which is encrypted using the transport key that was also generated during device registration. This session key can only be decrypted by the private transport key that is present on the same registered device. Again, as mentioned in the previous step, the transport key is protected by the TPM, so it protects against any unauthorized access. Going forward, this primary refresh token can be used on the device to enable single sign-on to all applications that rely on Azure AD for authentication.
Thank you, Ravi. That's quite useful to understand for all customers who have a federation provider. What about in a managed environment? Can you also explain how this works in a managed environment where customers have moved to cloud authentication?
Of course. In a managed environment, there are two key differences in how Azure AD authentication works. The first difference is that when Cloud AP does home realm discovery, it points back to Azure AD authentication endpoint instead of a federation provider. And the second difference is how Cloud AP sends the authentication request. In the case of a password, we send the user's actual password in the request on an encrypted TLS channel. But in the case of a passwordless credential like Windows Hello for Business or FIDO 2, the request is signed by the private key of that credential that is secured by hardware. After that request is sent, Azure AD validates the credentials and the rest of the authentication flow is exactly the same as the federated scenario where you end up getting a PRT and that PRT is going to be used for single sign-on to applications.
Thank you, Ravi. It's interesting how much really happens with a seemingly simple action such as logging from the Windows lock screen.
Yes, it really is, Gloria. So now can you explain how customers can validate that the authentication succeeded and a PRT was issued?
Sure. There are two ways to validate the authentication has succeeded and a PRT was issued to the user. First, you can run the /dsregcmd/status and check the Azure AD PRT output. If it says yes, then the user was issued a PRT. You can also see the issue time and expiry time in the output. The second approach is to check the Azure AD sign-in logs and filter by the application window sign-in to determine if the user has successfully authenticated on their device. Windows sign-in is a default application that is used to issue PRT for Windows logon. So a sign-in log for the application indicates that a user has successfully authenticated with Azure AD to their Windows device. We hope you found this video useful. We will be adding videos on different topics like authentication, multi-factor authentication, governance, and many more. Please see the description below for links to the diagram used in this video and other useful information. Thank you.
Thank you for listening.